Pierre sought information for a living. That is to say that ever since he returned from Korea, after having served with the armed forces, he had been working as a private investigator in Montreal. William Hamilton, a rich industrialist, had gotten in touch with him regarding a simple vandalism issue. Nothing to write home about. Not worth hiring a private eye either, just so he can drive for hours on rough roads. But that's how it had always been. The client pays, Carl gets it done. They had set up to meet at the general store, his client's business. Well, actually, the entire village had William Hamilton's name written all over it. When the roads were bad, muddy, or snowed in, it was customary around these parts to close them off. But it was also customary to ignore those signs entirely and drive there anyway. Emperor Duplessis, in spite of his conservative agenda, did a good job in colonizing the rural north, which helped to re-establish the region as an integral part of the province of Quebec. The blue fleur-de-lisée could be seen fluttering in the wind here and there, taunting the red Canadian flags on the other side of the province's boundaries. Still not a soul in sight. There was no point in waiting any longer. Carl had to figure this one out by himself. Hamilton is waiting for Carl in the general store. It was time for him to get down to business. Then enjoyed a lavish country house built in the very heart of the northern forests, not too far from here. The local populace was divided when it came to the affluent man. Some saw a wealthy philanthropist dedicated to improving the region's economy. Others an aging Englishman who would do anything to further his fortunes. And those ones hated him enough to go on about scheming against him. Hamilton had recently acquired a few local businesses, But the last straw was the reopening of a mine, which gave rise to a wave of protests and threats from the Cree people. Carl's military training had made him a very punctual man. Being late to his meeting with Hamilton was out of the question. Given these circumstances, Carl reckoned that a good number of people must be feeling compelled to oppose Hamilton in one way or another. So far, only the industrialist's house had been a target, but soon enough, Carl thought, the target would become the man himself. Carl's military training had made him a very punctual man. Being late to his meeting with Hamilton was out of the question. Carl needed to get out of there. The cold and the pain required urgent care. So cold, already Carl did not feel his toes anymore. Even better than he had hoped, Carl Faubert had succeeded once more and was now on his way to new adventures. The Polaroid, Carl's long-standing and faithful ally, has seen a share of husbands caught red-handed cheating. There's always something out there waiting to be snapped away. Carl, ever diligent in his work, always carried his log on him, in which he scribbled down thoughts and leads alike during the course of his investigations. turned into pain. Carl needed to find someplace warm. Driver had taken off. It was still best to check it out and leave nothing to chance. Carl needed help. It was a small, locked box engraved with the letters WH. Carl thought about taking it. Nothing was to be left to chance. spread out on a few acres of untouched forest, bellowing caribou, everlasting snow, and undefiled lakes. The Manistan region was no tourist hub. It was said to have been populated for millennia by Cree people, and ever since the industrial era, by the metal mining industry. Surrender their divine nectar so easily. In all likelihood, they had to be switched on from inside the store. Something fell to the bottom of the box. A milkman had to drive by every week to fill the bottles. The fresh milk indicated a recent visit. Carl had no trouble recognizing his employer. He had been killed. There was no need to be a detective to figure that out. But only a detective could have noticed that the killer had to have been very close, that the fatal blow had been given before the victim even realized. Maintaining his composure, Carl recalled something from his military training. Wolves always stay away from populated areas. Wait, was it about bears? Carl knew that Gilles Lachance was in charge of the general store. That made him one of Hamilton's employees. A very angry employee, as Carl could plainly see. According to that log, it seemed like the whole village owed some money to the general store. Carl was far more interested in the bunch of nearby addresses he had just gotten his hands on, though. Such heart-wrenching Nordic poetry, that was. But Carl didn't care much about flowery language. Carl was no electrician, but he could identify a wiring problem when he saw one. Prince? Carl found a surprise at every turn. Was the camera faulty, or was there a possible lead? Carl felt a chill down his spine and had a terrifying realization. If Hamilton was dead, then who was going to pay him? The snowstorm pummeled everything in its path. Carl was not surprised when he heard no tone. The pumps wouldn't surrender their divine nectar so easily. In all likelihood, they had to be switched on from inside the store. Carl knew straight away where to find the infuriated Gilles Lachance. Any good investigation would have to start there. The store and its surroundings still held their secrets, and he didn't like to miss out. Carl was used to strange phenomena, but a chunk of ice like this, as if an iceberg came out of the ground, that was a first. Carl wondered what the hell could that thing be. It looked like a man fossilized in ice. All of a sudden, Carl felt like he was pulled inside a world of dreams, a cold, unknown dimension. Somehow, self-control was slipping from his grasp. To all appearances, this was a hunting log. Better yet, a war diary. What could these engraved numbers mean? A fresh path suddenly appeared before Carl. That feeling you get when you immerse your frozen hands in hot water. What happened? Now at least he knew who the unfortunate man petrified in ice was. Gilles Lachance, the general store's manager himself. That had to be the worst parking job ever. Who was Carl to judge, though? It may be customary to park like that around these parts, or not. The murder weapon. What was that doing there, Carl wondered. Hamilton must have been determined to keep some information secret to post this key. Shame he got unlucky. Everything made sense now. Poor Hamilton's denunciation was interrupted, and he figured it would be best to lock everything up and send the key to his correspondent, who would receive the box later on. Clever, but not enough. That's what happens to ordinary people playing spies.